please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
At the moment, we are heading to London, the venue of IIFL's Invest India Conference. Nirmal Jain, chairman of IIFL, joins in. Good morning, Nirmal. Thank you very much. Well, actually, at the moment, India is facing a challenging macro environment. Well, I'm putting it strongly. Challenging as far as macro and rupee are concerned. Do you read these challenges as very severe? What are investors at the conference telling you?
So I think despite this challenge, which is on the currency as well as oil front, India is still very attractive. There's a lot of interest amongst foreign investors. On the positive side, we have seen that in the first quarter, India's economic growth rate, GDP, has bounced above 8%. And India is one of the fastest growing countries in the larger economies. And people have taken note of macro reforms that have taken place over the last four years. I think most of the investors are very enthusiastic. Some of them may be a little skeptical about the valuations, and they're trying to find good values. But I think there's no questions about long-term interest in investing in India. And these macro challenges, what you're talking about, I don't think they are so significant that should worry investors at this point in time. They're looking at India as a great investment destination for the next 3 to 5 years.
Okay, that's good to hear. After the fall that we saw yesterday, it makes you a bit skeptical. After a very long time, Nirmal, we've seen some kind of earnings recovery play through as well. Is that something that a lot of global investors are penciling in when they invest into India now?
Yeah, it is a very positive trend that we are seeing the earnings rebound. And people expect this to accelerate. And maybe after a lag of, say, 1 year, next year, we should see a much stronger revival in private sector capex or private sector investment as well. So many sectors are seeing earnings revival, which is very positive. And it took very long time for the corporate earnings to revive, but at last that's happening, and I think investors are happy about it.
Okay, the shift from retail banks to corporate banks is something that is probably exciting a lot of investors. We've seen it play out through the month of August. Are you getting the sense when you talk to investors in London that now people are looking back to the corporate banks, the corporate lenders in India?
I think if you see corporate lending, as I said, that private sector capex is still picking up and has some more time before it really gathers momentum. But yes, banking sector revival has to be balanced, and the larger banks will have to service corporates as well as retail. And I think that's a good positive sign.
Well, Nirmal, you also have a very large wealth and NBFC business. From an IIFL point of view, how do you think NBFCs will do over the next 12 to 18 months?
NBFC will do very well because the credit growth in India is very strong. And what we are seeing is that public sector banks are growing at a slower pace, and which is allowing private sector banks and NBFCs to grow at a faster pace. And wealth business also growing very well because we are seeing a lot of new money coming in with many promoters divesting part or full of their stake. And also, as the economy grows, we see that wealth grows at an accelerated pace. So both these businesses are showing very strong traction and very strong growth.
Okay, investors can also play the financialization theme now through sectors like insurance, AMCs, etc. And there's so much, growth here, so much competition. What is your personal view on the insurance and AMC business in India? What kind of growth do you see over the next 12 to 18 months?
All these businesses will grow very well. With the financialization of savings, you'll see financial securities and financial instruments like mutual fund, equity, insurance, seeing very good flow of money and much stronger growth in their AUM. So, that's happening.
Yesterday, we did see a big sell-off in the market, and a lot of people are talking about risks like crude, the rupee, the twin deficits, etc. According to you, what are the key risks that the Indian equity markets face currently?
So one is, of course, the oil and, the oil prices, because that can impact our currency, our fiscal deficit, as well as our current account deficit. Fiscal deficit, because still the price, you may not be able to pass on the entire price hike if it is very steep. And second is geopolitical problems outside, if it happens or it flares up. Emerging, anything going wrong with the market sentiment and therefore emerging market obviously will impact India as well.